Christopher Thompson. Welcome to another edition of Chris Speaks. Okay, so Thursday, went to school. It was between classes. I witnessed a protest that I became part of in the end, and it was Latino students protesting the fact that Donald Trump's gonna get rid of DACA, which is Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals, which would make it so people who were children when they were brought over to the United States from Mexico would be able to stay and have a path towards citizenship and be able to get a college education. And, well, Obama had started this. He had tried to get Congress to do something. They did nothing. He did a executive order, which he was hoping would force the hand and kind of push Congress to do something about it, but we know how our current Republican do-nothing Congress does nothing. That's why we call them do-nothing. So they wouldn't do that, and now Trump's going to overthrow it because he wants to overthrow anything that has to do with Obama, and he promised all these things to his xenophobic people that are backing him, that are so afraid of these Mexicans who are somehow are all on welfare and are taking their jobs at the same time. I don't know how that works. Anyway, so these students were protesting, and there's a part in here that really gets you, man. Okay, so let's see a little bit of clips from that. We'll see some of the marching, and then we'll see a couple of speakers come up.
People.
Okay, this part here when the girl in the dark shirt starts speaking is kind of, this is where it kind of got to me. She's talking about how she may have to go to a country and live in a country she doesn't even remember and all this stuff, and she begins to cry, and I teared up myself. So here you go, watch this next section.
Hard for her, you know. Oxford, he said that we have, we're a country of laws, and that we abide by the laws of the country. It's not about being sympathetic, but it's about upholding the law of the country. So my question to Jeff Sessions is, what happened to Joe Biden? How was it that he went and pardoned Joe Arpaio? And the reasoning behind that was that Joe Arpaio was 85 years old and that he served his country. Is that not sympathetic? That is being sympathetic. And if you can hear, be sympathetic to Joe Arpaio, a man who's a criminal, a man who treated people inhumane, which I personally don't condone, but if they saw against social homosexuality,
cannot have empathy for these people for not understanding. They grew up in the same place you grew up, here and there. There's nothing wrong with them. And people say, yeah, they're illegal, they're illegal. Well, if being illegal is the problem, wouldn't you make it easier for them to come in legally unless you actually have a problem with them? Surely this thing of making certain immigrants legal and certain not has nothing to do with hate. Well, wait, actually it does, because the first immigration law we ever had was the Chinese Exclusion Act. And they wanted to exclude the Chinese because they looked different, they spoke a different language, they didn't like them because they were different. And then it expanded to cover Europeans they didn't like, who spoke different languages and looked different and acted different. So, yes, it's all about prejudice. The whole point of how, just in our country, where we started with immigration laws, was because we didn't want people coming in who were different than us. And these people have been here, most of them don't even remember being in Mexico. And it's crazy to hear Barack Obama had to do what, he couldn't even get Congress to act. He had to do an executive order to get this done. And what does Donald Trump do? He overthrows it overturns it because he wants to overturn everything Obama does. Oh yeah, and he also, because he promised to protect America from the scary Mexicans. Anyways, just look at this, see this. Even you might have a difference of opinion, but you've got to at least feel for these people. If you don't, you don't have any empathy. Well, anyways, that's all I have to say about this, and just let the footage speak for itself. I'll see you guys again on the next episode of Chris Speaks.